Hi everyone, welcome to our new English video today. I am Megara, a teacher of English at Prelip New Generation School. Today we're gonna talk about Unit 5, Heroes, Vocabulary 1, Fundraising Idea. And last week we finished our Unit 4 with progress check. And we covered all everything we learned in Unit 4. And today we are going to cover everything in Unit 5, but it is the beginnings of Unit 5, Vocabulary 1, Fundraising Idea. And in this video, you will learn and practice what related to fundraising ideas and activities. And the second thing, you will be able to use words of fundraising activities in your real life. So don't waste the time. The first of all, I like to begin with your attention with our last homework that you got last week. And thank you for those have sent me the homework, and I found most of you have done the correct answers. But just a few of you haven't sent or haven't done the homework yet. So I just want to encourage everyone, please try to do it. If you get stuck something, you can drop and chat in our group, right? Right, so then let's start with our homework last week here. And I just want to go briefly because it's easy and some of you have done it. Just want to check the reason why we choose this one and why not that one. Right, let's start. Read the text and circle the correct answer. I think the blah 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 coastline in England is in Cornwall. You see, the number one have three choices. The first one, good, best, and better. So you have to look at the space. Should it be good, best, or better? So the correct answer should be the best, because the best is a superlative. It means you want to talk about the highest degrees of the place. There is only one place that really perfect or excellent for tourists. And number two, the weather there is. Number two have also three choices, and you can choose between clean, cleanness, and cleaner. So in number two, there is a comparative adjective with than. So you have to look for the word in the comparative form. The most correct answer is cleaner than in most place. And number three, of course, the weather is an S. You see, S and else. So you want to compare the same quality or it is not the same quality. So you have to use comparative degree. Warm, warmer, and warmest. So the correct answer is warm, because you just, because in the text there is S, blah blah blah, and S, right? So the words isn't as warm as Mediterranean, but it's not too cold and then to swim, for swim, or to swimming. I think the correct answer is to swim. New ski is probably number five. So the most S, right. So the correct answer for number five is the most popular beach in Cornwall. Then all the teenagers go there to surf, but it's right. So two, most and more. So you have to use two because more and more people go there and visit there. So too crowded for me. So many people or crowded people. I prefer Port Canal. If you go there, it should be warm enough to swim. You see, adjective plus enough. So you want to talk about there is enough for you, enough things, or enough waters, or enough something for you to do. And then go and visit outdoor theaters on the rock about the beach. It's got once off. So one off. The most correct answer is one of the most beautiful views in Cornwall. Dorset also has some wonderful coastline. It's not. So you have to complete with S, because S after Wales, you see the word S. So as well as the Cornish coast. So that's it for our homework, and I hope everybody gets the reason why we choose this one and why we choose that one. Last, I want to tell you that if you want to do this homework, you have to remember the form and the use of comparative and superlative, especially two enough rules. That's it. Next, I want to turn your attention to our today's lesson, which is about vocabulary one, fundraising idea. All right, so let's start. And then we will begin with the picture, and you have to see the picture and tell me the word and the meanings of those words. And then we do a few exercises together to check whether you understand how to use these vocabularies. Right, so look at the picture here. As you can see the picture here, there are a lot of dessert, candy, or any kinds of chocolate, a chewing gum, something like that. So the first word, we pronounce it sell sweets. You know sweets? Sweet, we refer to candy, dessert, or something it may conclude with coffee as well. Right, so sell sweet, it means to exchange candy, dessert to get money. Right, this is one of the charity activities or fundraising activities. And the next pictures and the next word is wash the car. And if you want to raise money for the charity, you can organize a group of people to wash the car in order to get the budget or to get the money for the charities. So as you can see this picture, three people are washing the car in order to get money to support the charities. Wash the car, it means to clean the car. Right, cap number three here, organize a concert. You know, organize a concert. As you can see the picture, organize a concert, it means to prepare a music concert for people. Sometimes you have to prepare the concert in order to get money for the visitors. After watching or while they are watching, they may give some amounts of their money to our charities. And the next word is about make a charity CD. You know, make a charity CD, and you can see the picture here. Make a charity CDs, it means to release song or some stories on the CD, and you sell that CD to other people in order to get money. Right, next word, we refer to swimming. Sometimes you do a sponsor swim, it means you volunteer to swim or do some kinds of activities in order to get and in order to gather to collect the money as well. For example, in these pictures, some people that they volunteer to swim in order to get a sponsor in order to get money for their charities. And the next word is about collect money. Sometimes you just walk and collect money by telling other people that this money is provided for our orphans or our charity. So some people, they are kind and they give you money as well. All right, next picture is selling badge. You can pronounce badge, right? So as you can see the pictures, it's a kind of souvenir things. For example, like in our Cambodia, we have Angkor Wat badge. So for tourists, when they buy, they can put on their clothes or they can put on their cap for the souvenir. And especially football teams, they often create or make badges to sell for their fans to earn some money for their teams. Right, and next word, we are talking about sell raffle tickets. You know raffle ticket? Raffle ticket, it means it's a kind of lucky draw ticket. Mean when you buy the ticket, you may have a chance to win a big prize for a group of people. And most often, the charity group often do this one in order to give a chance for other people, and sometimes to make other people enjoy doing this activity and give them the money for the charity or orphans. And then last two picture here is organize a jumbo sale. You know, organize a jumbo sale. As you can see these pictures, many people they organize like a jumbo sale, just sell for a few hours for a period, a very short period of time, in order to collect the money. And those things, it can be the things that reuse second time or second hand. For example, book, toys, or clothes that is good for second use, and they sell with a big price, and many people join it to buy. But the purpose of selling this because of they want to get money from other people to support the orphans or charities. And the last vocab is about have a print and buy sales. So print and buy sell, it means it's a kind of exchange goods. For example, like you have a store in that that activity, and you sell your product and others sell their product, and the others sell also product. You can sell your product in order to buy other product, in order to help each other to exchange the product to money. And there are various goods or various products can be sell or can be sold over there. And this also can be done in the classroom for our students as well. They have to create their own product and sell in the class. So they have to form teams in order to create a product, as you can see here, the picture. And last, we have 10 vocab. We have a print and buy sales, sell raffle tickets, do a sponsored swim, organize a jumbo sales, make a charity CD, sell badge, and collect money, wash the cars, organize a concert, and sell sweet. All right, so I hope at least you remember and can catch up some vocabulary that I am presenting. And now just want to do the exercise with me in order to get more and more understanding and remembering. Right, so look at the exercise number one here. Complete the fundraising idea with words in the box. So there are collect, do, have, make, wash, sells, and organize. So you can do you see the number in the bracket, two or three? So it means for example, have can be used two times, organize can be used also two times, and sell can also be used three times. Right, so look at exercise number one, blah blah blah, a print and buy sell. So what should be completed? The first one is have, right? Have a print and buy sales. And number two, raffle tickets. Like in the previous slide, I said raffle ticket, it means you have to sell, right? Sell raffle tickets. And number three, a sponsor swim. So what words should be complete in front of a sponsor swim? The best word is do a sponsor swim, right? And number four, a jumbo sales. What word should be complete in front of a jumbo sale? It should be organize a jumbo sale, right? And number five, a charity CD. So what does it mean, a charity CD? You have to complete with the word make a charity CD. And number six, badge. So badge, it means you have to use with sell badge, right? And then number seven, money. So the word money, you have to use with college money. All right, number eight, cars. In this vocabulary, car, you have to just wash the cars. And number nine, a concert. So a concert, you have to use with organize a concert. So mean prepare a music or concerts. And last one, sweets. Sweet is the first vocabulary that I have mentioned early. Sell sweets. Right? It kind of sweet candy, or sometimes you can say coffee or something like that, dessert as well. Alright, so this is about the vocabulary you are learning today. And now let's move to our exercise number two. Right, this exercise requires you to complete the spaces with the word in the exercise number one. Do you remember? You have to remember the word and you have to understand the meanings of the sentence as well. Alright, let's start with number one. Read the sentences and write fundraising idea from the exercise one. Okay, number one, have you got an old toys or clothes or books? Can you give me if you don't need it? So you see, the purpose of getting a second hand because they want to print and buy sales. Print and buy sell, like I explained earlier, you have to exchange a second-hand products in order to get money. Alright, number two, it takes about half an hour. It will be lovely and clean when I finish. You see? Do you see the keyword clean? So clean, it means it should be used with the wash cars. Alright? Good. And number three, it for children in Africa. Put it in the box, please. Thank you very much. So you see? Here, they want to talk about they are trying to gather the money. So they collect the money. The word, the best word should be completed here is collect money. Right. Number four here. She tried to do 1 kilometer. I'm paying her $1 for every 100 meters. So if she finishes, I have to give her $10. So you see, it talk about the racing, sometimes running, sometimes motorbike racing, bicycle racing. But in our vocabulary, we are talking about do a sponsor's swim. So in here is the correct word is do a sponsor's swim. Right. And number five, they say they save rent for race and they cost $20. Can I put on your jacket for you? Because if they want to get money to save the rainforest, they need to sell something, put on the shirt or t-shirt or cap like I explained. So the best word should be completed is sell bet. Right. And number six, tickets are $1 to give a chance to win one of this prize. So you see the word, the keyword ticket, so it means sell raffle ticket, right? So you have a chance to win a big prize. And last two sentences, number seven, we are singing and our teachers are recording us. You see, our teachers are recording us, so it means you make a charity CD in order to sell the CD to other people to gather the money. And the last exercise here, the last sentence, we've got chocolates. Chewing gum, you know, chewing gum, when you put inside your mouth, you always chew it often. And then everything costs $5. So, you know, chocolate and chewing gum, so it refers to candy. So the best word should be completed here is sell sweets. Right, that's it for our exercise number two. And now let's move to our last practice of our video today is homework. Now I want everybody to do this exercise as a homework and you have to complete the word in the box with in the spaces here. If you get stuck something, you refer back to our vocabulary part that we have mentioned earlier and I have already explained you all the 10 vocabulary. And I hope you get so far with this video and this lesson. And last things I want to recommend you is to do exercise and quiz and especially watch the video until you remember the 10 words. And this homework and the vocabulary will be checking and reviewing in the next video. Thank you for your watching and paying attention with me. All right, goodbye. Good luck.